Well, good morning. We are here at the Toning, and in our quest to bump it up a little bit higher, we're going to be doing some new stuff. We're going to incorporate some things that we've already done and kind of do them a little bit differently. Today is really a self-assessment. So just like every other time, this is your class. I'm just here to lead you, get in where you fit in. If there's something that you can't do, just keep moving. If you tap out before the time is up, just keep moving, walk, march in place. Just do something, just kind of move your body. But today I want you to test yourself just to see how far you can push yourself. You know, we never want to push ourselves so far that we're injuring ourselves, but see how far you can go and then see if you can do one more, just to see. Get you some goals, and that at least gives you something to reach for, right? So, I'm sorry, before we get started, this is SMBC F2, Faith and Fitness, Ministry of Second Missionary Baptist Church in Grandview, Missouri, where Bishop John Lewis Jr. is our pastor. My name is Kimberly Waller. Like I said, this is your class. So do what you want. Don't do what you don't want. Get in where you fit in, and let's see how we do. Okay, so some of the things that we're gonna do, some things I'll count them down like normal. Other things, we'll do them for 30 seconds at a time. And so once that 30 seconds is up, then we'll stop, we'll rest for 30 seconds, go on to something else, okay? One thing I'm gonna add that's gonna be every week is jump rope, okay? So either grab your actual jump rope or do your invisible jump rope, but we're gonna do it for 30 seconds at a time, and we'll probably do that for a couple times, just this first time, okay? So, let's go ahead and get started. Get my timer right here. Getting down all night. So, like I say, get in where you've been in. Doesn't matter what somebody else is doing. You do you. So if you're low impact and you're just starting out, all you gotta do is this. Okay? If you wanna move up a little bit, you can go knees up. That's gonna be a little bit higher. If you want to add a bounce to it, you can stay on your toes, but see how my heels are going up and down? So whether you have a rope or don't, see how my elbows are close in? You don't want to be like this. 3, 2, 1, jump. You can go as fast or as slow as you want. And if you are the type of person that says this is boring, you can add some spice. You can go forward and back, side to side, however you want to do it. I'm doing 30 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Watch your place. We're going to do that again. We're resting 30 seconds in between. This is a test for yourself. Just see how far you can push yourself. Get your arms ready. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. You can go side to side, twist it, or side to side, forward and back, or just straight. March in place. Good job, good job. March out wide. March inside. Out wide. 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 Inside. What we're going to do now is called a push-up, a low push-up hold. So we know that when we do a push-up, it's actually a plank that goes down and up, right? So, along with our different levels, if you are somebody that does your push-ups on the wall, remember, you have a flat back, and then you come in, this is where you would be. And then the second level after the wall is a chair. You would have a nice flat back, and then you would come down and you would hold here. If you're on the floor, get your mat. You're gonna hover right over when you go down. Ready? And go down and hover. All your weight is in the your palms. Halfway there. Five more seconds. Good job. Come back and stretch that out a little bit. Good job. Now we're going to do, move your mat out of the way. Nice wide legs. Feet out. Go side to side with some lunges. And we're gradually getting deeper in that lunge. So if that means you need to widen out your feet, do whatever you need to do. And then what we're going to do is we'll stop on one side, go deep in that lunge, hold it for 30 seconds. Get ready and hold it. Get low, get low, get low. This leg should be straight. All your weight is over here on this thigh. Don't have your hand on your knee. Make sure your hand is on your thigh. Halfway there. Now, baby pulse. Baby pulse. Up and down. Nice and easy. Just doing this for 15 seconds. Good job. Slowly, we're going to ease over to the other side. Go back and forth. Slowly easing to deeper and deeper. Then we'll go to the opposite side. Okay, get on that side. Get nice and deep. 30 seconds. Make sure all your weight is over here. Your hands are on your thigh, not your knee. This leg is nice and long, extended as long as you can. 15 seconds like this. Then we'll do 15 seconds of baby pulse. Baby pulse. I'm You should feel it right here on the inside. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. March in place. Next, we're gonna do some burpees. I told you we were gonna come back to it last week. Last week, or last time, we used it with a chair. And start here, and we went down. Kick those feet back, back up, and up. Sometimes burpees can be done with a push-up at the bottom. We're not doing a push-up. So whether you're doing that on the floor, on the chair, or on the floor, 30 seconds. Go as fast or as slow as you want. It's on you. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Go. Make sure you're breathing. Halfway. Good job. Get your sip of water. Just a sip, y'all. March out wide, march inside, out wide, inside, out wide, inside. Try to pull our heart rate down because we're going to hit the floor. If your heart rate isn't down, deep breaths. Deep breath through your nose and out through your mouth. Do about 3 of those. Grab your mat. Okay. Let's see. We're going to do some bicycle crunch. But instead of just, you know, how you normally have your knees going back and forth, slow it down. But we'll do it for 30 seconds. Let's see. I'm just waiting on my timer. Halfway.
Good job. How y'all doing? Back up on your feet. We're gonna do some squat jumps. So you squat down, jump up. Hands on your head. Get ready. Let's go. Make sure your elbows are back and don't lean all the way forward. Try to keep those shoulders up. Keep those elbows back. How's it going? How you doing? Get you some water. Good job. Watch your push. Watch our wide. Watch your place. Watch our wide. Watch your place. Our wide. Back inside. Legs shoulder width apart, toes slightly out. We're gonna do some squats. Make sure you squeeze your buns when you get to the top. Just waiting on my clock here. 9 seconds. Let's go. Squeeze those glutes at the top. Halfway there. Three seconds. Good job. Woo. Bringing our heart rate down because we're going to be on the floor. We don't have a whole lot of time left. Heels to the front. You know how we sit in the opposite knee so we can get a nice long leg. Heel becomes a toe tap to the front. Keep it going. Toe tap to the front. Toe tap to the side. Toe taps to the back. You should have a nice long straight leg. Are you back to regular breath? If not, deep breath in through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Four more of these. Three. Two, and one. Get your mat. We're gonna do some side planks. when we introduced this, we did it with our bottom leg bent. So you can either have that bottom leg bent and the top leg straight, or you can have both legs straight. But don't stand your feet when I talk to each other. Stand your feet. Okay? So when you lift up, you're going to lift your hips up. You're going to be on that top foot. Okay? Let's check our form. Our shoulders, directly down from my shoulder, is our elbow. Then your hand goes straight out from the elbow. Okay? We're going to lift up. I'm going to count to eight. Then we'll lower. When you lift up, don't sag. Bring the hip up. One, two, ready, and eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one, and lower. Good job. We're going to do it one more time on this side. Then we'll go to the other side. Make sure your placement is correct. Get ready. Here comes our second set. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Good job. Let's do the other side. Your format, your form is very important because you're resting all of your weight on the shoulders. So you want to make sure that it's supported accurately. So you don't want this elbow out and you don't want it in. And you see how I'm leaning on that shoulder at a funny angle? It's very important that the shoulder, that the elbow goes straight down from your shoulder, and your hand straight up from that elbow. You can either bend that bottom leg or have it straight. We're going to lift up, not sag. One, two, ready, let's go. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one, and lower. Ooh. One more set. You might find that one side isn't quite as strong as the other. That's normal, but it lets you know what you need to work on, right? Get ready. We're going to do one more set on this side. Then we'll do a couple abs. Stretch. And move on about your day. One, two, ready. Let's go. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. And lower. Good job. Go ahead and line your back. Gonna put your hands underneath your looks for support. Your legs gotta be straight. We're gonna do some scissors. So we wanna try to keep our feet as close to the floor as you can. That's gonna be more difficult. If you want it to be easier, the higher your feet are in the air, the easier it is, okay? But we're trying to push ourselves. So I'm gonna do our scissors down close to the floor and I'll count it out. One, two, ready, let's go. Eight, seven, lift your head, six, five, four, three, two, and one, and lower. You can leave your head on the floor, but your goal is to lift your head up while you're doing your scissors. We're gonna do that two more times. Here comes our second time. Ready, and eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Release. Good job. Just have one more set. One, two, ready, let's go. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Good job. Woo!
We did it, y'all.
Let's stretch. 30 minutes goes by really fast. Arms over your head. Legs nice and long. Hold it nice and tight. And release. Relax. Let's do that again. Arms and legs tight. And release. Gotta do that one more time. Arms and legs tight. And release. Bring those arms around to your side. You're gonna bring both knees in. I know that we normally, and hug those knees. I know we normally do one knee at a time. Just trying to show you some different options. So hug those knees tight against you so that your thighs are up against your body. Now take both arms out to the side, palms down. You're gonna keep your shoulder blades, both shoulder blades on the floor at all times. You're gonna gently drop both those knees over to your right side. Both shoulder blades are still on the floor, and your head is looking over your left shoulder. Take your time. Lift those knees back up to the middle. Take your time. Lower those knees over to your left side, and your head is looking over your right shoulder. Lift those knees to the middle. Hug them tight, tight, one more time. And release. Go ahead and stand up. Nice wide leg top. Woo. Hands all the way down to the bottom and hold. Go to that right knee. In the middle. And to that left knee. In the middle. Take your time. Slowly roll that back all the way to the top. Roll those shoulders when you get to the top. Take your feet. Use your legs to walk your feet in. Good job. Take that right heel. Get that heel on the ground. All your weight is on this left bent knee. Your hand is on your thigh, not on your knee, on your thigh. Sitting into that knee. This leg is nice and straight. Your toe is pointing up to the ceiling. Sit into that stretch. Put that toe down. Pull that toe up, grab that toe. You feel a stretch all the way up and down the back of that leg. All the way up. Release. Let's do the left side. So dig that left heel on the ground. Sit back. And all your weight is on that right knee. That toe is up. Straight leg. Put that toe down on the floor. Toe up, grab that toe. All the way up. And release. Arms all the way out, wide, wide, wide. Feel a stretch right in here. and you're trying to pull your shoulder blades together in the back. Take your right wrist, pull it up and over. And release, wide right arms. Bring your left wrist up and over and pull it up. On top of our arms. Hands on your thighs and make a flat back. Arch your back. Flat. Arch. And flat. Last time. Bring that right shoulder around to the front. Left shoulder. Right. And left. Take your time, roll that back all the way to the top. Roll the shoulders back. Let's do four big shoulder rolls to the back. Take your time. Four, three, two, and one. Reverse it to the front. Four, nice and big. Three, two, and one. Take that head. Look straight up to the ceiling. You feel stretch all in your neck. Look straight ahead. Take your time. Put that chin on your chest and hold. Straight ahead. Look all the way over your right shoulder. Back to the middle. Look over your left shoulder. Back to the middle. Roll the head all the way around to your right. Nice and slow. I think I went the wrong way. And reverse. Just go the opposite of whatever you just went to two times. Two pleasant breaths and we're done. Deep breath, take your time. Release it nice and slow. That's how you breath. And release. You know how we do. Take that right arm in. Bring that left arm in. Give yourself a hug. Everybody deserves at least one hug a day. And I know I say this every week, and I'll continue to say it, because this is the truth. We need to learn to love ourselves so that we can love other people. So how did you do? Did you make any goals? Did you meet any goals? Did you exceed any goals? Did you not quite go where you thought that you would go? Any and all of the above is fine. If you reached or exceeded your goals, now you know what you can do and where to go next time. If you didn't quite hit your goals, you know what to aim for. And if you just fell completely off, just think, you're this much closer to being healthy. You're this much closer to being fit. You're this much closer to all those things that you're trying to get than you were an hour ago. And you're this much closer than the other folks that didn't even try. Okay, so we need to learn to celebrate our successes as big or as small, because they all count. One step at a time, and don't forget that baby steps do count. So thank you so much for coming. I'm honored that you chose to spend some time with me, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.